Hi everyone, so happy you took the time to come over and watch a new video of us. For everyone who is new here, my name is Yanni and I'm doing this channel together with my daughter-in-law Diane. And of course today is again a special day because I am joining Kisha from Sweet Urban Rose and of course Carrie from Mama Dares to DIY in their challenge which is called You Nailed It or Failed It. So you have to take a decor item and you have to make it in a very budget friendly way, so you have to make it in a much less than you would buy for in the shops or on internet. So I did my best. I took some decor piece and I tried to make it for a lot less. At least for me it was nothing. So I hope you enjoy seeing how I made my DIY and how I decorated with it. And of course for the channel from Kisha and Carrie, of course I will put a link down below in my description box. Go check out their beautiful channels and please subscribe to their channels. And of course I will put a link down below with the playlist for everyone who is joining Kisha and Carrie in their challenge. So go check the playlist out and go subscribe to everyone who is joining. You won't be disappointed because there are so many beautiful creators. So go check everyone out in the playlist. And now for enough talking, if you like our videos also, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe also to our channel. We would love to have you here. But now, like I said, enough talking. Let's jump into the video. So you see here my little wooden birdhouse. And like you see, it's very light because it is not a very heavy wood. You see already I had it in the Mackenzie Child theme, but this time I'm going to try to make something of a little birdhouse of the Ray Dunn. A lot of you know the Ray Dunn series, of course. They are from the birdhouse, they are in the white and in the black. And of course here in the Netherlands we don't have a Ray Dunn, at least we cannot buy them here in our shop. So I will try to make something on my own, and I hope it will look like the Ray Dunn you all can buy. They are very expensive usually, so I am hoping that this one also will look a little like the Ray Dunn style. So of course I will insert a photo from a Ray Dunn little birdhouse and the price with it, of course. So now I'm going to start my DIY. So here you see already one of the Ray Dunn birdhouse, and he looks a lot like my little birdhouse. And of course he is in the white color and he is $50, similar like 50 euro here in the Netherlands. I love this one, but I'm going to for a little bit of the black kind. So I'm looking a little bit further for the black one. Yes, I found the black one, and of course you see here he's a little bit similar like my birdhouse, also just like the white one, only this one is I think in a black color and he has a little different text on it. But I love this one, and of course I know the underside is a little bit smaller than my birdhouse, but I love my birdhouse so much. So I'm going to try to make this one a little bit similar like the Ray Dunn's. And of course here you see the price on it, he is $44.90. I hope my camera will focus because he's seeing me behind the camera in the shininess of my iPad. And of course, but I hope you can see this one I'm going to try to make. So let's jump into our DIY. So now I did my metal ring on it because on the birdhouses of the Ray Dunn there is also a ring on the upside. So I have this ring, it's a little bit big because I have this one and he was too small. So I'm going to look if this one will work, and now I will paint it in totally and then I will look how it turns out. So I hope that it doesn't look funny when it's painted all black. Thank you. Looks like right now. I think he turned out so cute. Of course, I know that the sides are a little bit wider than the original Raydan, but I love how he's turning out right now. And of course, I also painted two little birds for my display, so I'm quite satisfied with it. But I don't know if I filled it or nailed it. I really don't know. But I think he is cute. So let's decorate. So you see what I will use for my little display. I will do it this time in a crate. Because I will place them in my wooden boxes on my wall. So I will decorate this crate. And of course I will do a background of this black and white buffalo check. Of course. Like I said, I also painted two little blackbirds and I will use some little wreath, some greenery. I keep it very simple and neutral this time, so I just I'm going to cut this out, but I won't bore you with that. I will cut it out and show you then how it looks like in my crate. So you see, I already cut this one out, so I will do this one on the bottom of my crate with some sticky gum. You don't have to use a lot of sticky gum. A couple of pieces are more than enough to keep it in place. It is just that you don't get wrinkles on the back side, because you put the crate on the side, so that then you will see some wrinkles. So that's why I always do some sticky gum. Of course you can glue it in, but then you can get it out, and I will change most of the time my decor very much. So we will put this one over here, and of course here. I will show you this in a moment, because I don't know if the camera will pick it up right now. So you see here, now you already have a little background already for your piece. Now I will do my, I hope I don't have you too high, I will do you a little bit lower so you can see a little bit better. So I think this is a little bit better how you can see it. Of course I will place my little birdhouse in. It just really just fitting. And of course I have my blackbirds, and of course I will do them with sticky gum also inside of the crate, because I'm a little bit afraid if I don't do that they will fall off and then they will break, because it's not really porcelain, but yeah, a little bit of, I don't know if it's clay, I don't know really what kind of stuff it is, but I will hate it if they would fall off. So I'm going to look how I will have them in my display, because they both look the same size, so that's not really, and there's not so much room for it, so I really have to look where I want them. But as always with decorating, you just try something. Maybe someone piece in the background. I will first try a little bit. I don't know if I will place them both, but if you do this you see this just similar to each other, and that's not really the look I'm going for. So I'm really hesitated how I want them inside of my little display. But I won't bore you with that. If I have found if I found the way I want them, I'm back with you. So you see, I still haven't found the way I want them in my display. So, but I think I will use one little bird and I will use little wreath. You see, just a little twine wreath, and I do some sticky gum under it, so I will that he will stay a little bit in place. And of course, I have to place him on the wood. And now I will do one bird over on the little wreath, and I think this is more than enough. And now I will put some greenery in, because me without greenery is a little bit strange. And of course, for everyone who likes it, of course, at the picture of the redan, at the knob at above on the roof, you can do a little piece of ribbon. I don't do that because I have already enough plaid in the back side of my crate. But of course, you can also do that. But for me, this is more than enough. And now I will put the greenery in. And of course, greenery is for me always bringing my displays coming to life. Because of course, this is also for someone who likes this, it's fine too. It's really pretty. But I always love that my centerpieces are coming to life a little bit. So of course, you don't need to do the greenery. It's just something I do. You don't have to do that, of course. And of course, now you see already my, when you don't keep it stuck, you already see my bird is already falling. So I will do some little pieces of old greenery and I'll put them beside and behind the little bird. And now I, of course, I didn't put the bird, and of course some over here. And of course, I have to try to get something under my little birdcase. But you will see, it's always a little bit of a struggle to get it inside of the place that I want it to go. And of course, I want some pieces of, at least the little pieces of my lambs here, because I want like the pop of color in it. This is a big one. I really need the smaller ones. And of course, you see here in this crate, you don't need a lot of. Here's also still a little one. I squeeze them under here beside the little house. And of course, I want the house a little bit at the side. So, and of course, you can do some little pieces of hydrangea or something of another flower, something of like gipskruid, but of course I won't do this time, because I think it's already busy enough. And of course, you can do a little wreath at the background also with some sticky gum, but for me this is more than enough. I do some loose pieces of this greenery. Of course, I love to mix and match everything with each other. So for me, I don't follow a special rule for you have to do this, you have to do that, because I always do whatever I think it's fitting. And I see here I have still different kind of shapes, and I think maybe at the background over here I like a little bit more of a green touch. And of course, I will do place someone at the back over here, so it gives a little bit more of a height behind my little display. And of course, I have to watch out that I don't do my bird totally disappear. But of course, in my display I have a light, so there will be a spotlight on this little piece, so there will be enough light to see. So I will show you in a moment how he really looks like in my wooden box, but I think he turns out quite nice. And of course you see here again, like I always say in my video, I'm just also an amateur and I'm just doing something, just a simple create, just a little print at the back. And of course paint something you have already in your home, or what you drifted, or this is already very old, and of course the birds are already very old, and I change them in a lot of colors. If I don't like it anymore, I just spray paint it again. So, and the greenery is also so you can use every time and time again, so you don't have to buy a lot of things over and over again, because you have more than enough mostly of the time in your stash. So I will put this in my wooden box, and then I show you how it look like. So you see here my little one of the wooden boxes I have over here, and I will put the lights on. At least I try to put the lights on. You have to use, of course, the remote control, which is the right one. But here we are. Here is my little display, and you already see he lights up very nice. And of course, now you see this side, and of course, this is not done yet. I'm going to keep it out, or pull it out. Of course, my old wooden. This one is also very, very old. I bought, at least in the sale, I bought it at least 20 pieces, or even more. And I use it, the last time I used a lot again, but at the blah, 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 blah. I'm so sorry. But the period before that, I keep it a while in my stash, because I used it a lot and then I didn't like it anymore. But I thought I don't throw it away, because maybe I will use it someday. And I do, because now already I like it. So don't throw things away, and just keep it in your stash, and you can use it always later again. So this one I will use, but of course I still have my other black bird I already see here, and of course I will put my wooden here, and of course I put some greenery around him. For people who is taking it too long, just skip forward. So you see, I'm just doing some greenery around him. Maybe I can do him a little bit higher with a little wreath. Like you see, the little wreaths are so easy to work with. So just place a little wreath around him. Just the bird on here. And of course, now I will get my glass dome on the bird and on my. So if I am lucky enough, then he will fit, and he still does fit. So I will do some greenery also around here. And of course, some little piece of my wooden wooden garland, I don't know how you call it, then still do some pieces of greenery in it. Just, I always do what I will, the greenery I use here, I also use over here, so you get the same thing over here than you have over there. That's so it makes it look fitting to each other. But you have to make sure that you still are seeing the bird. And the bird is already a little bit black, because, and I will do my spotlights over there so they will see more. And of course some over here, some lambs here. I know he will fall, because today is just a day that everything is falling down. But I think you all have one of those days. I think I fit him over here. So this one over here. Now the other greenery. You see here I used this one also earlier, and now I just make a little groups of greenery so they are look like they belong together. And I think I do a little piece over here. So just squeeze it a little bit in. So I will show you that now in a moment if I would do a little. I hope I don't blind you with my little spotlight. So you can see what I do first this one. And then later I show you the other one with light also. So you see just how easy it is. Just a little display with some little old birdhouse, some birds and some glass dome and some old pieces, and you already have a new display. It's so easy to do. So, but I show you in a moment how he really looks like. So I show you now with a little extra light on it, that you don't think what is this, so much light. But I do, of course, a little bit with the extra light on it. So you see here how cute he looks like, just in a simple wooden box. And of course, I hope that you also can see a little bit, because it's very in the glass, it's very glowing. So I hope you still can. I will go a little bit behind. You see already I have one box of my wall decor I already decorated. Now I have to do the other boxes. But I think he turned out so cute. I say a lot of cute, and I say a lot of a lot of words the same. I'm sorry for that. But like you all know, it's always chaos around here. So, but I think he, I don't know, leave in the comments down below if you think I nailed it or just filled it. If you don't like it, it's okay too, because everyone can have their opinion, so it doesn't mind. I think he turned out right, but if you think he doesn't look the same like my picture, of course you are totally right, because it is not completely the same. But I think I did come a long way. And of course, there's another little house who says home on it. It's also from Radon, a black one. And he says home on it. I also could have done that one, but I liked this one the more. But of course, if you don't like it, you are free to say so also. So, but this was my little display for one of my wooden boxes on my wall. So this was my DIY from a birdhouse from the Radon series. I hope you think I nailed it, but if you think I failed it, it is also good to know. So let me know in the comments what you think of it. I hope you liked seeing at least how I made it and get a little bit inspired, just how easy it is just to decorate with a couple of things. So Keisha and of course Carrie, thank you for hosting this great challenge. I had a lot of fun joining you, and of course for everyone who is here and loves this content, please subscribe also to our channel, and we would love to have you here. And from Diane and me, I wish you all a beautiful, beautiful day. Take care of yourself, take care of each other, and please stay safe in this crazy world. So we hope to see you in another video. Love from Diane and me. Bye.